you know that there's an iron monster that helps Chinese workers to build entire bridges? And that China built an entire bridge in less than 2 days? Today, we're going to be exploring China's fantastic technology to build bridges. But before we continue, share your thoughts with us. Do you know how bridges are built? Let us know down in the comments. China has been the global leader in bridge construction for decades. The Chinese government has committed to investing billions of dollars annually in bridge construction to meet the demands of rapid economic and social development. The country is known as the world's largest builder of bridges. By the end of 2017, China had built more than 830,000 bridges. China is internationally renowned for its engineering prowess. All of this can be attributed to the country's strong tradition of bridge construction and its work in various bridge projects spanning different industries. So far, China has built more than half of the world's longest cable-styled bridges. They also have 6 world's 10 largest suspension bridges, with main spans in the top 10. The bridges in China have a long history. The first bridge was built in the Sui Dynasty. They were mainly built with wood and stone. However, the bridges were not as advanced as their Western counterparts because they didn't use iron or steel to reinforce them. In the late 1980s and the early 1990s, China started to build bridges with concrete. From then on, the country soared with unique technological projects, including the longest bridge in the world. The Danyang Kunshan Grand Bridge stands at a length of over 164,000 meters. And as if that wasn't enough, China is the world's most prolific builder of bridges. In 2016, for example, China built more than half of the world's new bridges. In short, construction technology in China is very innovative. It's become a booming industry with the integration of new technologies. Construction technology as an industry has been developing for many years, and it's always been ahead of its time. Bridge construction technology innovations are becoming increasingly sophisticated, and the future of bridges will be shaped by these innovations. The Internet of Things is one of the most significant technological innovations that will shape bridges in the future. So far, we know China's place as a leader in bridge building, right? But how the hell are these bridges built? How do you build high-speed railways with large sections suspended in beautiful valleys and massive cannons? And fast, too. Well, it's all possible thanks to a bridge-building machine called SLJ-900-32, or as the workers like to call it, the Iron Monster. This machine is designed to build long bridges consisting of many spans. It works on the moving, installing, and securing of finished segments to the already installed supports. The construction of bridges using Iron Monster still requires manual labor, but on much smaller and less frequent occasions than other technologies in the past. You might be wondering how massive the Iron Monster stands. Well, at a length of 91 meters, 7.4 meters in width, and a height of 9 meters, the weight is an impressive 580 tons. But this machine doesn't only impress with size numbers. It's also incredible when we talk about efficiency. The Iron Monster is capable of laying around 750 during its lifespan. However, more than 40% of the machines showed an even greater performance, laying about 1,000 bridges in the course of their working duration. I bet you learned a lot so far. To keep watching awesome videos like this one, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. It means the world to us. Now, let's talk practice. How does this bridge-building machine work through each step of the way? First, the Iron Monster lays out each section. Next, it returns to collect another block with the aid of its 64 wheels, and then the machine rolls over the piece it just laid to place another section. A side note about the vehicle is that each wheel is part of a fully rotating block of 16. This means that the wheels can also move sideways. The machine is still quick when pushed to its limits. At its maximum weight capacity, the Iron Monster can move at 5 kilometers per hour, which is faster than traditional methods. This way, the Chinese constructors can keep the extremely tight schedules set for the conclusion of these bridges. The machine weighs 580 tons, which is heavier than any railway track that would pass over the bridge. This means that bridges are built to be far stronger than necessary for everyday use, because the weight of the machine that constructs it surpasses everything else. Since its implementation, the Iron Monster has contributed to various high-speed rail projects, like a new line between Mongolia and the rest of the country. That's pretty impressive, right? But the Iron Monster isn't the only highly efficient bridge-building method, as was proved by this next incredible feat. China replaced an overpass in under 2 days, 43 hours to be more exact. How did they build something from scratch so quickly? The story is as follows. Beijing's famous San Yuan Bridge has been replaced with a brand new one in 43 hours. A record 43 hours. This feat happened a few years ago, but it's still impressive today. Some of the bridge's old supports began to weaken, causing severe safety issues for the people passing underneath. And thus, the government issued an order for the bridge to be rebuilt. Initially, the plan was for the construction project to be finished in 24 hours. However, the workers soon realized that there was more damage than they had originally predicted. So they extended the time frame accordingly. The bridge was demolished within the first 24 hours, with the remaining 19 hours seeing it recreated and opened again. Motorists were back on it in under 2 days. Traditional construction methods can take months or even years to conclude a project. Luckily, the Sanyuan Bridge in Beijing was one of the first structures to be connected with this new integrated replacement method, which meant that it could be dismantled much faster than older structures. The operation was a big one, and it encompassed more than 1,300 tons of new surfacing material. It was also a time saver. Had traditional construction methods been used, traffic would have been affected for at least 2 months. But instead, China took a bold new direction and tried their new integrated replacement method, which is largely used today. This method is more commonly known as prefabricated construction. Buildings can be made in a factory. Entire buildings, too. A prefabricated bridge is a manufactured bridge in a factory or a workshop, and then transported to the construction site. This type of bridge is built off-site, which means that it can be constructed quickly, leading to cost savings. There's many advantages to prefabricated buildings, including reduced construction time as well as reduced on-site work. Prefabricated bridges are created in a controlled environment and are assembled on-site. This results in reduced construction times and works on-site. These bridges are also stronger and more durable, as they undergo rigorous testing during their creation. In the case of the Sanyuan Bridge in Beijing, the workers installed an entire bridge in one piece rather than building it up using individual parts. Two giant mechanical pulleys helped slide the 1,300-ton slab of the pre-built roadway into place. Prefabricated construction had been discussed before, but up until this point, no one had dared to use it in such a daring feat. After quick paving, the road was ready to go. You want to see the whole process? Check out this amazing time lapse. So, which bridge construction method is your favorite? Let us know in the comment section down below. If you want to see more about similar projects, then you can check out our video, Chinese Engineers Shock American Scientists to the Bone. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.